today. From Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, Florida, it's the AFC Divisional Round Playoffs on EA Sports. Tua Tagovailoa and the Miami Dolphins taking on Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs.
Playoff fever has immersed South Florida as we are at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Coming up, it's Divisional Round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Miami Dolphins. Hello, everyone. As the postseason continues here on EA Sports, we're pleased to bring it to you. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And who has the edge here? We got one side that had some extra rest, but another comes in off a win last week in the wild card round.
And it's funny, depending on which team you are, you say that that's an advantage. You'll take the rest, you'll take the week off, get your guys healed up a little bit and ready to go. But that team that's coming in off of a win last excited to keep playing. They feel like they are hot and ready to go.
So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. They will be led out by the 6-foot lefty from Alabama. It's Tua Tagovailoa.
In playoff games in and of themselves, we know they're pressure filled. That's not breaking any news, but you have to wonder how much added pressure this team feels given that a perfect season is on the line. They heard it during the regular season. Now they've sat at home for 2 weeks hearing about it. Can they handle that as well as the team that they're facing in order to try and advance?
And he'll get about four across the 30 to the 32. Now it appears we've got a Chief moving pretty gingerly down there. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. On second down, a run with Breida.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
5 yards. Now it's third and five. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady game.
Well, that's good for a first down. Here's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of the playoffs. Yeah, this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
At the Chiefs, 30-yard line.
Tua going to hand this one to Breida. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of four.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off this young quarterback. And no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Tagovailoa going to try and throw on third down. They'll set up a screen to Belage. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Miami Dolphins. First and 10 at the 13.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. From 13 yards out. And the Dolphins take it right down and score on the opening drive. I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass his young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. impressed. Aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen, and it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
Kick this one away, and off it goes. Here's Mecole Hardman. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The KC offense set to go, led as always by the gunslinger, a former MVP in this league. It's Patrick Mahomes.
And he more than did his part. The wild card win with three touchdown passes. Now, he's going to get a bigger test here in round two. But his unit is in rhythm, and they're playing as well as they have all year long. I wouldn't be surprised if this defense, though, tried to get after him early with a little extra pressure. If he can handle that, he can have another big game, though.
Mahomes now on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. And that will be incomplete. It would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of four. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And this is caught by Watkins. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. This seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they responded pretty well there. You go three and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down two scores, it could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot in the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
It's a gain of 8.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter.
31-yard line.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
He was taken down at the 20.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy's setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Mahomes dropping one to Williams here. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
Complete.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space. It turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And third and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive.
And that's exactly what offenses try to avoid by using motion and throwing different formations up. They hate when he can draw a bead on the play, get a running start, and make a big play behind the line of scrimmage as he did just there.
2 catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down. Williams. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. From 10 yards out. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
A good tight end is a heck of a weapon for any quarterback, especially when you're able to create some mismatches. Sometimes they work against a linebacker, sometimes they work against a smaller defensive back. But when they find it, they go to it, and it often results in touchdowns.
Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Jakeem Grant now to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at at their own 29-yard line.
So Miami coming out for their second drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it didn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield. When they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football, I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line.
The tackle by
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Three brings up second and seven at the Chiefs' 45-yard line.
Play action. Now it's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down.
2 yard line.
They go counter with Breida. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down.
Breida,
a quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
It's a gain of five. Brings up
now on third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Tua sets up to pass it. Oh, it's a screen pass. It's complete. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 17-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
First and 10 at the 17-yard line.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. These two teams all tied after one. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. They run with Breida. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now. But you talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
A gain of 2 on the play. Brings up 4th and...
They run for it with Breida. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. They'll try to run with Breida, and he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out, and the Dolphins have taken the lead. He's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So that one, a long 11-play drive. And it was Matt Breida who had the touchdown run to put it into it. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Here's Hardman on the return. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
Cole Hardman on the return. The Chiefs take over first and 10.
Kansas City taking the field for their second drive. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. That's complete to his tight end, Seals Jones. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. They'll bring out 4 receivers, 3 of them being sent to the left, 1 to the right, 2nd and 4. Now Mahomes. Going to throw right side here, complete.
Mahomes. One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And that's going to be a Chiefs first down as he gets it up past the 35. Give him 5 yards there, and it's enough for the first.
And the first down, Chiefs.
Mahomes now to throw. And he'll find his tight end, Seals Jones. A gain of six there on first.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Throwing again on second down, Mahomes. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Emmanuel Ogba. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Going to need better protection here. Third and long following the sack from Mahomes and company. And that will be incomplete.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
On is the punter, Townsend, as he gets this one away. Here comes Grant on the return. So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards. And it'll be Dolphin football. That breed in the offense heading back out. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the second quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had. Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here.
At the 44-yard line.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A gain of 13, it's a first down. This is Breida. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
That's good.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
On first down, here's Breida. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about four. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And this is caught at the 8. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for first and goal.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Tua gonna throw. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, third and goal. Here's Tua. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Two catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron, had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes
you throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now 21-7. The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
The Chiefs take over first and 10.
Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. 7 yards, the pickup there.
That's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
But he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. Short throw. This is Seals Jones with it. And he will have a Chiefs first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on 3rd and 1. Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Now here's Mahomes. Caught out left side by Robinson. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Mahomes used to moving quickly in college, trying to get his guys to the line. He'll drop this down to Williams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Mahomes now on 1st down.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
Mahomes throwing complete there to Robinson. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll get an update when we come back to Miami. They go play action. Now Mahomes. The Dolphins do the job defensively there, and now it brings up 4th.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
They run. It's Williams. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. The Chiefs tried it, but they're turned away on 4th down. And the Dolphins' defense is able to hold.
Partner, when you see a running play stop short like that, you just know that the defensive front, they won the battle of leverage and created the push back into the opposing backfield.
And for the offensive coordinator, whether you had 1 yard to go or 20 yards to go on 4th down, now you're probably saying, oh, maybe I should have passed it, right?
Yeah, hindsight is always 20-20.
A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
And throw right side complete to Parker. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Well, that's good for a 1st down. There's a guy who went over 1,000 yards receiving in the regular season, and now he's got his first catch of the playoffs. Running out of the gun here, Breida.
Do what we
and he'll
do.
Take
do
this what? Into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida with his 2nd touchdown here in this 1st half. And the Dolphins add on to their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the 1st half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Sanders now to add the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it was Matt Breida who had the touchdown run to put an end to it. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one. It's through the back of the end zone for a touchback. Set to take over, Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. And how does he rally the troops, so to speak? He's played well, but they're down big on the scoreboard. How does he get his guys going?
to make sure they understand it's not a me game, it's a team game. Everyone has to come together, everyone has to up the level of play a little bit, including himself, and find a way to make some plays in order to give them a little bit of a spark and rally the team.
We'll see if they can indeed rally down big on the scoreboard right now. Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes complete. The tight end, Kelsey. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
First down, Kansas City.
Throwing now is Mahomes. And open left side, it's Williams. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. To throw again on second down. Mahomes firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. So it's on the halftime of this AFC Divisional Round matchup as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. This, the first of four Divisional Round matchups coming up this weekend. We'll get back out to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's take a look ahead to tomorrow's other Divisional Round games in the AFC. And it looks like a good one, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens matching up against the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, in our game, we've got one half remaining to find out who goes on to the AFC title game. And to bring it all to you, let's send it back out to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Win or go home, that's the name of the game. Back underway with the second half of this AFC Divisional Round. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own.
Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They're down three touchdowns to this point, needing to put something together as they have it first and 10. Mahomes going to throw. Gets this one to Hill. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20. A big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. Working from the gun, Mahomes. To the right side, it's Kelsey. Not much there, only a yard.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Throwing again on second down, Mahomes. Throw right side, going to be caught by Seals Jones. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll get an update when we come back to Hard Rock Stadium. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he could break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he could scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Take over first and 10. At their own 20.
Matt Breida, the offense, heading back out. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they are really in sync right now.
They'll start on the ground with Breida. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Anthony Hitchcock.
He'll come up now, second and four from the 31.
Well, I think after that run, the defense get back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
And he'll have a Dolphins first down as he's able to get this up to the 37-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Third down and 3 yards.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And it's caught by Parker. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Two catches now in this divisional round matchup. That one, a first down. Now it's Breida. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
The tackle by Damian Wilson.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. They follow up the first down one-yard run with a minimal gain of two.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
He'll give up 6 yards there on the loss, and it'll bring up fourth down. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up. They were able to read that one and slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down, and the Chiefs' defense comes up with a stop. Well, their first fourth down attempt earlier was successful. This one backfires for a turnover on downs.
I like their aggressiveness. I like what they're doing. They got it the first time they went for it. Why not a second time? I don't think they'll be daunted from attempting it again. If you're on the defensive side of the ball, though, any fourth down stop is a big momentum play.
Mahomes dropping one to Williams here. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And it'll be third and 10 now. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And this is going to be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. We'll call it a 42-yard punt, three on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Matt Breida in the offense heading back out. And there are the numbers. Got off to that torrid hot start. We thought he was in for maybe a career day. Not the case.
No doubt about it. It almost looks like a misprint after what we saw in the first half. But let's give a little bit of credit to the guys on our side of the ball. They went into halftime, made a few adjustments. And you know what else? They didn't lose their confidence in how their ability to play.
And now look at That's him go! And all the way in for the Miami touchdown. Matt Breida sending his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead.
So, Matt, another touchdown. They're looking like the number one seed that they earned throughout the year. Looking pretty dominant right now.
We knew the road to the Super Bowl would run right through this stadium. Somebody's going to have to come in here and beat these guys. Good luck. I don't think it's happening this weekend.
No, definitely not this weekend. And for anyone else out there, bring your game.
Buyer, beware. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
Chiefs 7.
Kick this one away, and off it goes.
Here's Hardman on the return. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped it to 23-yard line.
The Chiefs take over first and 10.
The Chiefs ready to rock again on offense.
They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
A gain of 13 yards. First down, Chiefs.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Throw right side, complete to Williams. A good rally to the football. Keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
Brings up second and 9. At the 35-yard line.
To throw, it's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
He's going to look deep for Watkins. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
So one first down on that drive, and that's it. Forced to take the deep shot on third down and couldn't hit it. Now they have to punt this one away.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Returnable for Grant. Very good return that time. 18 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Tua Tagovailoa and the offense heading back out.
They haven't had to rely so much on the passing game. It's really been a team effort in the running game that's kept them successful and has them in the lead.
I like that, too, the team effort, because when I was growing up, one guy carried the football, right? You stuck it in his chest 20 to 30 times a game, and he was the heavy volume, heavy dose guy. Now, you spread it around, different people touching it, and in this game, it's proven to be effective.
And spreading the wealth has been very effective. Out of the shotgun, Breida, and he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory. Derek Nnadi makes the tackle. They run again with Breida. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
That's a gain of 3. Now 3rd and 5. That's the end of the 3rd quarter.
One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've been very good, 5-for-7 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. They'll set up a screen for Breida. Dancing away at the 30. And he's taken down inside the 30. First and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Tua, a give. This is Howard. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
Speaks on the tackle.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Brings up 3rd and 1.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. And they'll get this down to the 10. Give them 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
Tell you what, partner, the way he's been slinging in this one, I think he should be ticketed for a baseball cap and a set of headphones for the next drive. He's been absolutely sensational. But one thing we've both learned about quarterbacks in this league, they often stay on the field longer than you expect.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage. And now they're going to get him down right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain. I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
Here's Breida. And a nice pick up there, so take it from the 10 down to the 5-yard line. They'll break the huddle and come up on the ninth play of this drive. And he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Dolphins just continue to pour it on. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead will swell by one more. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
This taken in about 4 yards deep. And bring this out to the 25. No return there for Hardman.
The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field.
Their hopes of advancing past this divisional round hanging by a thread, if that, as they begin here with a first and 10 on the wrong side of the scoreboard.
They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. They'll contain him to just 4, second down.
At the 29-yard line.
Here's Mahomes to throw. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
A gain of 13 yards. First down, Chiefs.
On first and 10, here's Mahomes. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Boy, how good has this defense been seemingly all game long?
I really think right from the first snap, I think you're really onto something there. In this passing game, it just can't get off the ground. In that play, it wound up losing yardage.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes, that one complete to Hill. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
3-yard pickup.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
He's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll get this up near midfield, but that's still a few yards shy of the first down. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a 4th down. Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. Oh, this is off the side of his foot. So out of bounds on the punt, and the spot will be, the side judge says, right at the 35-yard line here.
Tua and the rest of the Dolphin offense heading back out.
And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they've made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
Have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing them all sorts of trouble.
A drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Now a give to Breida. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. That one good for 13 on a Dolphin first down.
Oh, that's is one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, pulled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Soft through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Pickup brings up second and three at the Chiefs' 34-yard line.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Off of play action, Tagovailoa. Got a man on the right sideline. It's Parker. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. An excellent pickup of 20 yards.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Nice gain of 8 that time, and it's second and goal. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. I'll call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And that is going to set up 3rd and goal. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. About a half yard from the end zone, 3rd and goal. Tua setting up shop to throw again. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12.
A 5-yard loss.
They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just added their totals.
Touchdown, Dolphins.
He has really settled in throwing the football. And that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie, but he's playing like fourth quarter. And the QB is easy. How about this guy? Youngster, not worried about anything, just cutting it loose and having fun.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. And this is going to be caught. So add 2 more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
I think this is just going to be a function of the times we live in now. Very similar to the bat flip in baseball. Everyone's got to start to get comfortable with this. But to me, this is just rubbing it in. You got a big lead. Go ahead and take the extra point. One thing to keep in mind, though, karma's still out there. And sometimes it has a way of catching up with you.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And now here comes Kansas City.
They knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter.
Mahomes now on first down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3.
2nd and 3 at the 32-yard line.
Now here's Mahomes. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10.
Kansas City.
It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Throwing on 1st down is Mahomes. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
At the 36-yard line.
The Dolphins advancing in these playoffs as we say so long, everybody.
Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports.
The Dolphins are winners here as we say so long from South Florida.